Hi, my name is Daniel, and this is a video tutorial based on a publication that we presented this year in Acta Paleontologica Polonica. In this paper, we describe a modeling method that allows to graft virtual models of ammonoid shells. This technique was used first by Dr. David Peterman and his colleagues in 2018, and since then some researchers like me have been using it to study ammonites and other cephalopods. So, in this tutorial, we will explore the principal steps of the method. For this, you must have learned the basics of 3D modeling in Blender, that is the program that we will use throughout the process. In the description, I recommend some useful tutorials that you can find on YouTube. Well, Blender is a free 3D modeling platform with a lot of applications, going from physics simulations to CGI. It works with simple geometries like this cube that is formed by vertices, edges and faces. Editing the vertices, we can change this format. Going forward, to create a model of a cephalopod conch, you need to create a tube-like object, that in the paper we name as segment, which is basically a wall section. For this, you can use a cylinder that you can add from the object list or create it modifying the original cube. I prefer to use the cube because it is easier to work with and is less computer demanding. So, to create the tube-like geometry, I will erase these faces and then use a subdivision surface modifier with 3 subdivisions. You can add more if you want to smooth the surface. Then rescale the geometry on the x-axis. This is the basic segment. In order to emulate a real cephalopod conch, you must modify his dimension and adjust his shape. Here we will use this simple object for simplicity. Following, we will add thickness to this segment to emulate the shell wall. In order to do so, add a solidify modifier, adjust the thickness, and then apply the modifier. Go to edit mode, and erase the faces on the front and the back of the segment, to avoid the problems with the subdivision surface and the array modifier. You must close this object at the end of the process. Rename the object. This will help if you want to add more things to the scene later. Go to object mode again and add the array modifier. Check merge and object offset. Then add another object. Here I will use a cube, scale it and then apply the transformation. Rename it as Object Offset. Select the segment. In the Array Modifier layout, select the object offset that we just added. Add 100 iterations of the segment. The number of iterations depends on the capabilities of the hardware and the segment thickness or LGT parameter in the paper. Select the object offset. Go to Object Properties, scale the cube and add a rotation. These are the array parameters in the paper. So this is the basic theoretical shape for any cephalopod conch. You can experiment with the rotations and the relative offset to explore more morphologies. Then you can edit the vertices to close the gaps. Notice that when you edit the vertices, the relative offset will change. Precise measurements can be used to adjust the overlapping. You can edit the loop cuts to add ornamentation such as ribs. For a basic septum, select the inner layer of the segment, create a face and then insert it. Further, you can edit this surface to increase its complexity. You can add a model based on photogrammetry of the mold of a chamber and then subtract one of the surfaces to emulate the septum. In the paper, there wasn't one of these molds available for the studied species. As you can see, it is not a difficult technique. The most challenging part consists of the extraction of the morphometrical data to emulate the real specimen. Well, this is the end of the tutorial. Thanks for watching.